Hi, my name is Matthew Rocknich. I am the developer evangelist here at DocuSign. I'm here today in Chicago with Keith Litwin, who is a senior director of engineering. Keith, thank you so much for being here.
Thanks for having me, Matt.
So Keith, how did you get your start in software engineering?
Well, so I've been in technology for a little over 20 years. I started out during the dot-com boom selling computer equipment, really loved it, went back to school to learn software engineering. Since then, I've worked in big companies like Oracle and IBM, as well as smaller startups. And then I came to SpringCM, been here for a little over 9 years. I started out as our lead solution engineer, building custom solutions, worked my way up to VP of engineering, which was my role at the time that DocuSign acquired SpringCM.
Very cool. So what are you currently working on? What's your focus?
Kind of two main focuses. So we're building out some new products that are leveraging the SpringCM platform, as well as we're continuing to build out our contract lifecycle management solution, which is part of DocuSign's overall system of agreement.
So contract lifecycle management, what exactly is that?
Well, that generally refers to a secure platform that allows you to generate documents, route them for approvals, and manage negotiation and redlining. Really, it helps you automate any document-centric business process. Now, within the context of DocuSign's system of agreement, SpringCM fits perfectly into what we call the prepare stage, where we're enabling customers to create and collaborate with one another prior to sending out the agreement.
So it sounds like SpringCM brings a tremendous amount of value to our customers, but what about developers? I was very excited to hear that SpringCM has a REST API. What specific functionality is accessible to our devs?
So the API allows developers to work with SpringCM's documents, data, and services, and pretty much almost anything that you can do inside the SpringCM user interface is exposed in the API. The way to think about it is that the API is broken down into kind of three logical sub-APIs. There's the object API, which is your standard create, read, update, delete operations. Mm-hmm. Examples there might be I need to create a folder, delete a folder, create a user, create a group, put a user in a group, those kinds of things.
Right.
There's the task API, which you can think of as being like asynchronous background tasks, or I want to give SpringCM a piece of work to do on my behalf. And examples there might be generate a document, run a search for me, zip a bunch of files for download, and that kind of thing. And then there's the content API, which is working with the documents themselves, which would be like upload, download, and versioning of the documents.
Excellent. I suspect a good number of our viewers are relatively unfamiliar with CLM. Do you have a demo you could show us?
I do, and what I'm going to talk about today is one of our most common use cases, which is contract lifecycle management within Salesforce. And so to set the stage for that, we're going to use an example scenario where we have a sales rep, Ernesto, who needs to close a deal. And he needs to generate a sales order, and part of sending that out will have to go through an approval from his manager, who's Keith. I'll play that role. And then Kathy is our customer that will ultimately have to sign it with DocuSign electronic signature. So what we're going to show is dynamically generation of a document based on Salesforce data. We'll show how the routing and approvals work, and then we'll ultimately see our sales order go out for electronic signature. Okay, so here we are inside Salesforce on an opportunity that we're going to use for our demo. In this case, like we talked about, here's our opportunity, Ernesto, and he's our sales rep that's going to generate a sales order. We're here in the contract legal space, ready to send this out for review. So I'm going to go ahead and click Generate Sales Order, and that's going to take us into a new tab, into the SpringCM Document Generation Wizard. And what you can see here is that it actually dynamically pulled data from Salesforce in here, and you can see the adjust information is pre-populated, the primary quote information is pre-populated, as well as the quote lines. And then we can do some interesting things in here, like if we wanted to attach some additional documents out with our sales order, or we can come down here and let's say we want to switch our payment terms from net 30 to net 45. Now when I switch that, notice what happens here. We have a rule that was set up that said modification of payment terms require management approval. So this is great for our demo, for our phase two, when we want to send this to a manager for approval. And then I'm going to go ahead and click Next. And so this is building our document preview. It's taking that structured data that we just pulled here into the wizard. It's taking a Word template document that we pre-created, and now it's showing us a preview of what our document's going to look like. We can see our order form. Here has the data pulled in from Salesforce, nicely formatted, that's ready to go out to our customer. Now, I'm going to pause over here and pull up some code. So let's say, for example, we're not using Salesforce. We have some other third-party system. It might even be some homegrown system that you have, and you want to do document generation, leverage a wizard like we see here. You can do things like as simple as creating a template and choosing which one you'd like to like to use, creating some structured data. In this case, we might have queried a database or something along those lines. And then doing a simple post to the API, say, here's the data, here's the template I want, and it gives me back a URL to go ahead and launch the wizard. And there's even the subservices underneath that. Let's say I just wanted to generate the document. I could give it the structured data and a template and just say, we don't need the wizard, just generate the document, and off it goes. So next, I'm going to come in here, and I'm going to go ahead and save the document. And that's going to take us back into our Salesforce opportunity. And what we're going to see when I scroll down here, that our document has now come in and is associated with our opportunity inside a SpringCM folder that's associated with it. And I'm going to take a look at the generated document. And there's lots of interesting things that we see. So the first thing that we see is the current stage. So the document was generated, and now it's gone straight into manager approval, because we saw that earlier, that that's what was required for Net45. I've come over here now to attributes, and the document was tagged with the data from Salesforce. So inside SpringCM, we could use this data to do queries and searches, reporting, that kind of thing. And then there's all kinds of actions we can take on the document. So we could upload a new version, and we can send for external review, we could share it with somebody, we can maybe look at the history and other pieces around what we've done here. But for our demo, let's assume that we want to build, let's say, a mobile application that's leveraging this document and do something interesting with the API, or maybe surface this in a portal or some third-party application. So let's take a look at what the document looks like in the API. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab this document's unique identifier right here off the query string. And I've set up a test harness where we can query the API in real time and see what this document looks like. So I'm going to go ahead in here and populate this field with our document ID. And I'm going to go ahead and query for it. And what we can see back is we get back our document object, our API representation of our document object, our sales order, description was agreement and review like we saw. And then we can start to see these child objects that are associated with it. For example, here's our parent folder that the document is in. You can see it's not expanded, but it gives us an endpoint that if we're interested in the parent folder, we can do a query on it. So I have that set up already for us over here. And I'm going to go ahead and query. Now what's interesting is I look at the, you know, with some standard things like a name, created date, updated date. I've also see our child set of documents here. So like we saw, we our new generated document. And then what's interesting is this object called EOS info. And notice that it has the object ID from Salesforce and the object type of Salesforce opportunity. And what's interesting, when I asked for the document up here on the query string, excuse me, asked for the folder, I have Salesforce opportunity and EOS object ID, which is the Salesforce object ID, and then set expand equal documents. So here right on the query string, I'm actually querying by the third-party system, Salesforce's object ID. So when the folder was created, we tagged it. And that way, if, let's say, you're building your own application that needs storage, you can use data from the third-party system and not have to manage, like, SpringCM object IDs and things like that yourself. So let's go back to our document object and look at that a little bit further. And as we scroll down, we can see some of the objects, like attribute groups, are expanded. And that's because on the query string here, I said, you know what, when you give me this document, I don't want to make callbacks like I just did for the folder. Just give me all the attribute groups and this other object document process tracking activities right on the first call. And so here you can see, just like we saw in the UI, we can see things like our quote number, who prepared the document, the quote expiration, and things like that. And that could be used in our custom mobile app to show the end user. And as I scroll down, you can see all the other kinds of things like security around the document, how to version it, whether or not I want to share the document, that kind of thing. And then we get to our document process tracking activity. And this is an interesting object in that it's actually showing us the approval. So for our end user, we can say, you know, it's assigned to Keith, it's in status, for it's status waiting for the manager to approve it, and then what potential user actions are. Now, in a normal CLM use case, we wouldn't necessarily come into the document first. We would, because the manager's not navigating to the opportunity and looking for things for him to do, we just want that to sign directly to him. So in a normal use case, he would have something like this, like the SpringCM inbox tracker. And inside here, when I refresh, it says, okay, well, it's meeting for management approval, so these are the tasks that are assigned to me. And if I were to click review here, it takes a slightly different view of the document. It takes us straight into the approval flow. Now remember our three phases where we said first we're going to generate the document. So we've gone through that and we kind of saw what the document looks like. Now we're kind of in the second phase where we have to do a manager approval. Okay, so let's dig a little bit deeper and see what that looks like in both the UI and the API if we were building our mobile app. So inside here, you can see that this particular approval just is a simple one. It just says approve or reject and allows you to do some simple comments. In this case, the workflow is set up to say approve. It will go out for DocuSign electronic signature. In the case where we would reject it, it might be sent back to Ernesto or sales rep to go ahead and make some changes. We can give them some comments and things like that. Okay, so let's come back over here to our test harness and see what we can do here. So I have another query set up. And this is basically the equivalent of what we just saw in the inbox. So give me all the tasks that are assigned to Keith. And in the API, that's actually considered a work item or a piece of work that an end user has to do. So here you can see I've queried for user slash, and this long GUID is actually my user ID, so I had that preset up, and then slash work items to say, give me the actual inbox or the collection of work items that are assigned to Keith. And so here we can display to our users, say, here's all the tasks that you have to do, and allow them to potentially take action. So if we want them to take action, I'm going to go ahead now and grab the unique identifier for our current work item right here. And I'm going to set that in our variable so that we can make some queries against it. So I'm going to go ahead and do that right here. And let's make sure that we have the right object. I'm going to go ahead and query directly for that work item. Now, when I query directly for the work item, notice I get a little bit extra information. I get this selections array here. And it gives me the options of what the end user can actually do. They can either approve or reject. In the case where we do something more complex, you'll have other options there. We might prompt the user to choose another user to do the additional approvals or maybe extra documents and things like that. But in our case, we're going to do a simple approval. And let's say we wanted to approve this with comment. I have a patch set up here. And our payload will look like this. So now we've chosen selected. The item was approve, right? Then we can do some of approvals might have multiple options. In our case, it's simple approval. And then our comment, this is a great demo. We're going to post that back to the work item endpoint. Click send. Okay, so we got back 200. And let's go back to our Salesforce UI and reopen up the document and see what happened. So now we immediately see that the status of the document has changed. So we see the manager approval, you have approved, it's gone out for electronic signature to K1174, which is our test user, which would normally be Kathy customer, which is stage three that we talked about. So now we've done the document generation, we've done our approval, and now the final phase is out for signature. So let's look a little bit closer at that. If I come back over here to our document and just query for it again, we can see now our document process tracking activity says send for signature. And it can tell that it's in a waiting status. That's SpringCM waiting for it to be signed, for it to come back in. We can see that it was signed to klitwin74@yahoo.com. And if we come back over here to actually the inbox, we can see that the signature request was sent out by Ernesto and said to go ahead and review the document. Okay, so our first phase, second phase, and third phase will now be complete once it's signed. Now, I've been talking a lot about workflow, and that's an important piece of the story here in terms of we have the UI and the API that's interacting with these work items. And what we've done is pre-created a workflow here that kind of models the business process. And we've been mostly talking about the prepare phase, created the document, now kicked off this workflow. We can see that some decisions were made about the document, comes through to approver one, where we saw that we programmatically executed on that in the API. And once that was completed, then it came in here to the signing phase, and once they sign, then there'll be some downstream activities with our act and manage once the document comes back from signature.
So Keith, what's the best way for developers to get started with Spring?
So I encourage anybody who's interested in the SpringCM APIs to first check out developer.springcm.com. There we have all kinds of information about what you can do with the API, a lot of things that I didn't show in this one. And then when they're ready to start coding, to reach out to their SpringCM representative.
Awesome. And are there any jobs available for engineers in Chicago?
Oh yeah, we're hiring across our entire technology team. We're looking for full stack engineers, UI engineers, QA, operations. So I encourage anybody who'd like to join us to check out the DocuSign job site.
Great, thanks for chatting.
Hey, appreciate it.